I'm going to sign this part of my act. Growing up with two deaf parents meant that I cried a lot as a baby. It takes some time for some of you. Yeah. You can laugh at that. It's okay. My parents won't hear it. You're good. Yeah. You just got it. He audibly said, I just got it. It takes some time. Okay. We're not all winners. It's okay. All right. So.
How to call somebody a whore in American Sign Language. All you gotta do is take your hand and do this. Whore!
Last night, a storm blew away 25% of my roof. Oof.
This is gonna be fun. Let's say that you're supposed to get a text message from a friend today, and then for whatever reason, you don't. What is the immediate assumption that you make? Like the first thought that pops into your head? If your answer sounds anything like you get really upset because you just assume that they don't like you anymore and they don't want to speak to you ever again and you must have been a terrible friend the whole time, you might want to stick around because today we're going to talk about rejection-sensitive dysphoria. So first off, what is rejection-sensitive dysphoria? RSD is defined as extreme emotional sensitivity to real or perceived rejection. It's not a diagnosis of anything. Rather, it's a term that we use to describe a sort of group of trauma symptoms and emotional dysregulation. RSD can be really hard to live with. It can turn you into an absolute people pleaser who will do anything to be accepted. Or you go the opposite direction and just completely stop trying. RSD is exceptionally common in people with ADHD. It can affect everything from business to personal relationships to even your sex life. I talk about this a lot, so check the playlist for more.
When you mix up idioms, you make a malaphor. Here's some of my favorite examples. Shit or get out of the kitchen. Or there's more than one way to bury a dead horse. If you can't stand the heat, get out of the fire. If we can't grab the bull by the horns, we'll milk it dry. The devil is in the pudding. Fool me once, shame on you. But teach a man to fool me and I'll be fooled for the rest of my life. Whatever blows your goat. Scooby-dooby-doo unto others what you would have them yabba-dabba-doo unto you. That sure is a tough nut to swallow. This may come back to haunt you in your ass. The road to hell wasn't paved in a day. Beauty is in the eye of the tiger. I can't make head, shoulders, knees, or toes of it. But we'll burn that bridge when we get to it. There's more than one way to bite the hand that feeds a man a fish. A penny saved is a penny. And my favorite one I came up with is, when in Rome, all roads lead to there. What are your favorites, or what can you come up with? Let's see in the comments.
Hey, girl.
Hey, but I'm not a girl, actually.
What do you mean?
Well, I'm non-binary, so I prefer gender-neutral verbiage, and I go by they-them pronouns.
Isn't that plural, though?
It can be used as a singular as well. For example, where did they go? Can you give that to them? Do you know where they went?
Oh, I see. So you can use they or them if you're not sure if you're talking about a boy or girl.
Right. Or if someone doesn't identify as male or female, or sometimes if they identify as both.
Huh. I never thought of it that way. Thanks for taking the time to explain it to me. I really understand it now and will be accepting of not only your identity, but of others I meet in the future as well.
Gobble me, swallow me, trip down the side of me, quick jump out for you, lady, get inside of me. I ride on the thing like the cops is behind me. I spin on his mic and now he's trying to sign me. I give his fire, put on it, sorry, it's going and dry and it's coming out soggy. I ride on the thing like the cops is behind me. I spin on his mic and now he's trying to sign me. Yeah, you mess it, it's wet and gushy. Pick him up, it's an hour for this wet and gushy. Give me everything you got.
Hello and welcome to today's episode of Church Signs That My Followers Have Sent Me That Are Definitely Not Funny or Suggestive in Any Way Whatsoever. First off, we have Bella Vista Baptist Church, Forgiveness is Swallowing When You Want to Spit. Okay. Second, we have Hickory Flat Fellowship, The Best Way to the Top is On Your Knees, if you say so. Third, we have Gospel Harvest Church, The Lord Is and Will Come, Has He Came in You? No. Fourth, we have Forest Hills Evangelical Free Church with the timeless Bible verse Psalm 16:11. In your right hand there are pleasures forever. Praise the Lord. Open Door Baptist Church, Jesus is touching you. Please stop, Jesus. And finally, we have the House of Prayer. Eat the devil's corn, you will choke on his cob. That's too bad. We now have this honorable mention, Blue Ball Baptist Church.
If you see a pothole the size of a Volkswagen, drive right into it. Be a man.
Bada dee bada. Bada badee dee. Bad dab.
I'm not gay. I'm not straight. I'm bi. By myself.
Who's that fun-ass thing I see over there? This you?
Hey, dragon, not lizard. I don't do that tongue thing.
Dumb shit I've said to guests at work and gotten away with. This is part two. Yeah, I'll have the chuck roast, please. And can I have the halibut? Alright, sure, I've got the roast Charles and the halibooty coming right up for you. The what?
Reduce. Reuse. Ikiki.
Knock, knock. Knock, knock. Hi. Hi. Hello, Faith. What? Oh. That's not helpful. What? What? Can I have a kiss? What? Thank you.
Tell me your dog's name, then all the ridiculous things you call them besides their actual name. Pickles. Fickles. Ficky. Pickly Wickly. Farmer Pickles. Spicy Meatball.
Damn, it really do be beautiful outside right now. But you know what it's not beautifuler than? It's not better beautifuler than you.
Welcome to today's episode of Church Signs That Really Should Have Been Proofread. We're starting out strong with this entry from Forest Mill Baptist Church. Pray for a good harvest, but keep on hoeing. I will. Next up, we have Mount Olive Baptist Church. A 4-inch tongue can bring a 6-foot man to his knees. Third, we have Fairview Baptist. You can't enter heaven unless Jesus enters you. No, thank you. Mount Olive Baptist Church with the personal questions. Easter comes once a year. How often do you? Fifth, we have West Side Church of God. A loose tongue often gets into a tight place. Sixth, we have Church of Morongo, short, sweet, and to the point. Is the Lord your daddy? Please. Seventh, we have the Trinity Church of Christ. Real friends don't rub it in. They rub it out. Stay tuned for part two.
If it hadn't been for God and I, Joe, I'd been married a long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from, Cotton Eye Joe? If it hadn't been for God and I, Joe, I'd been married.
A message to my best friend. I miss you, bitch. I never gonna stop loving you, bitch.
You two new blue do. A paint nap is New Zealand map. High top sun chimes. Dinner bag, fine toothpicks. Bus stop foot long, the rooster. Kids covering songs, cayenne pepper. 5 cleaning rags, I pot some dimes. In a bag, 9 glue sticks. Bottle pop, Marlon the trooper. This Parmesan, this phenomenon, this banana, this common log, this kind of dog. Vinyl seat, somebody's hefty yacht, I'm in age. Cowpie 40s, this nothing, cross accounting, no page. Rawhide pudding, bean chair, cow juice wouldn't be pears. Now I'm good, Hattie Claire's, and another beach chair. Kickstand triple, best blue kitchen sink, toast sign, so hand do's tubes. Panda hammock stew, book about makeup, small sandwich table. Quick and two, kitten soup, all new licorice chews. Chicken soup, yoo-hoo pinkish, frilly kickin' shoes.
If someone sent you this, they are either coming out to you as trans, please ask for their pronouns and give yours in return, be respectful. 2, they just committed arson and they either need you to help them hide from the cops, or they just want to show you the thing they burned. Or 3, they think you're kind of cute and if you want to be more than friends, maybe look into that.
What do we want? Low-flying airplane noises. When do we want them? Meow.
Is it just you and me?
Post me a pic, finna make me a profit. When the liquor hit, then the bitch get toxic. I've been lit since brunch, that shit. Order 42 for the table, let's pop shit. Missionaire or doggy style on my top shit. I don't give a fuck who talk behind my back, cause the bitch knew better than to let me hear.
Hands on my knees, shaking ass on my thigh shit. Hands on my knees, shaking ass on my thigh shit. Hands on my knees, shaking ass on my thigh shit. Hands on my knees, hands on my knees. Hands on my knees, shaking ass on my thigh shit. Hands on my knees, shaking ass on my thigh shit. Hands on my knees, shaking ass on my thigh shit. Hands on my knees, hands on my knees.
Translating metal songs so my girlfriend understands them better.
We are the antidote and also the disease.
Translating metal songs so my brother understands them better.
My final breath swallowed by the womb of death. The fucking gate! Descending towards the end!
The Watch Sign Language Interpreter went in.
So how exactly do you navigate a roundabout? Many inexperienced drivers are intimidated by their unique layout. However, in this video, we will show you exactly how to navigate through them, and you'll find that they are actually not complicated at all.
Oh, stop right there! I've heard there's something wrong with you and I must give you a medical immediately. Head up for me. Okay, look to that woods, look to that woods, up to the upwards. Down, that's very good. Open your mouth and say, hua! And now look at me again. That's very good. Follow the finger. Do a little twirl for me. Stay right there, don't move. Okay, good. I'm sorry, I have to tell you this, and it is very unfortunate. It's unavoidable and terminal. But I diagnose you with hot as hell, and there's nothing we can do about it. Squish! Love you! Bye!
Into the thick of it!
Into the thick of it.